ancient business, a modern piece of glasswork. Down on the corner that you walk each day in passing, the elderly sales clerk won't ask with suspicion. The whole of motor corporation's giving its permission.
Sí, ya está controlado. Ahí está. Ya no hay espora, ¿verdad?
Sí.
O sea que todavía nos falta un poco de conocimiento de la enfermedad. Este año ya agarramos más experiencia. El año pasado no teníamos nada, nos agarró.
Porque a esta altitud no necesitaba hacerlo, la fumigación años atrás. Ahora.
Nunca se había hecho.
Ahora se va a plantar nuevo.
¿Se planta cuándo?
En mayo.
En mayo.
Inicio de las lluvias.
We have just been in Santa Cruz, Naranjo. This is south of Guatemala City. It's the area of Santa Rosa. I came here in January. I was impressed by how badly it was struck by Roya. It was in fact, in the records, the worst struck area in the whole of Guatemala. And to my great satisfaction, what I saw this time was a totally changed scenario. I saw that the dynamics implemented by Fedecocagua through its local cooperative and its leaders here, has made a fundamental change. I've seen that in a community with about 130, 140 coffee producers, small holders, between 5 and 10 manzanas each, whereby half of them, about 65, are members of the cooperative. Their trees are looking great. Their trees have the Roya, but it's living in common with the evolution of the leaves, in common with the evolution of the fruit, the maturation, and they will produce coffee and will also I also saw a series of replantings, and I saw a series of prunings. On the other hand, the independent producers, which represent half the group of producers here, did really nothing until recently, as some of them saw the examples of the cooperative members, plantations. They started also to spray, fumigate and spray against the Roya, and they're seeing some results. So I think it's going to be an off year in production here. By all means, maybe the 40% reduction will confirm itself, but next year this region comes back very strong, comes back with a good production, with sound trees and sounder leaves in general. They have learned to survive and to live with the Roya. It was a great experience to see that.
You have now seen the three previous episodes about me revisiting the Guatemalan coffee regions, chasing the Roya 2013. And this fourth episode here is the final one, and I think it's important that I give my expression, that I give my impression of what I've seen and how I foresee the situation developing with the Roya and the coffee production in Guatemala. And I must say that although I firmly believe in a reduction of production for this year now, the 2013-14 crops and the next one, all due to the pruning, to the replanting, and also due to some residual plantations of smallholders which have not yet produced any reaction, any combat to the Roya, I must say that what I saw was very impressive. I have seen that not only the producers which are linked to the cooperatives, not only the producers strongly attached to the ANACAFE cycle of information and training and participation, but also the independent smallholders have been supported by the private initiative, or by their own means, have also started to invest in the combat against the Roya. As a general situation, a general view, all these changes, these dynamics, which have been very positively and very efficiently implemented, have also supported the future coffee production in Guatemala in other areas. For example, they're combating the Roya, but also now another kind of fungus, which is the ojo de gallo, and as well are the boar, the broca, is being combated. There's a lot of a new plantation scenario in all areas visited, a lot of new planting still to come. The management, the agricultural management, has been totally revamped, revived, so everyone's paying attention. And I think that after these couple of years where productivity will be smaller, we will arise into a better scenario, a scenario that is much more promising than what was the scenario before the Roya. And Guatemala has another important support for its coffee production and its properties. That is that most Guatemalan families, especially around the smallholders, they do have
couple of members of their family living in the United States. And these people, these Guatemalans living abroad, they promote the highest influx of dollars into Guatemala on a yearly basis, something around the $4.5 billion a year. This money has shown to be the alternative economy to these smallholders, because where I thought they only dependent on coffee, I now know that they have a more diversified economy, and these lands, these properties will not be sold, they will not be abandoned. For example, the year where Guatemala, the recent year with highest prices where Guatemala had a strongest influx of dollars from coffee sales, this number represented only $1.2 billion, 1.3 maybe, against the same $4.5 billion of influx from money transfers, wire transfers into the country, family to family. So the Guatemalans will be able to remain as proud coffee producers, and are using part of this money to invest in the dynamics to fight the Roya, to improve productivity, to add additional varietals, and to stay in the business of producing coffee. I repeat, I am very impressed with what I've seen. I'm very impressed with the whole campaign, the collaboration that has happened between ANACAFE, Fedecocagua, the exporter community as well, and the people, the producers. I can only welcome this example and hope that it can be reproduced in other Central American countries that suffer from the same Roya plague at the moment, the same fungus. I can only say again thank you for everyone that received me in Guatemala with such open arms and open spirit. And that I'm very impressed by the work that everyone is doing to remain producing great coffees. And as I said, maybe in a couple of years, arise in a situation and scenario with more abundance of quality and enough coffee. Thank you.
But the way I'm living seems I'm getting down every day. The more I strive, the less I'm alive, and it seems I'm getting further away. Oh well, all my superstitions and my crazy suspicions of the people that I care about, I've been doing most screaming, and I've been doing dreaming, and I think it's time I figured it out. Yeah, baby, I need a plan. Oh, to understand the life ain't on supply and demand. Well, I've been going jogging in the park after dark, dragging around with me my ball and chain. It took southern skies to make me realize that I'm causing myself this pain. Well, the woman that I'm loving, yeah, I'm pushing and shoving, getting further on by the day. And I can't understand how the heartless man ever let it end up this way. Baby, I need a plan. Ought to understand that life ain't only supply and demand. When the road is dark and lonesome, dear, you can find me here. But honey, you don't know where I am. You need a friend. It's easy when you're the big man in town. Shaking religions and making decisions, you never get to slow on down. Where your wife and your baby, you tell them, yeah, well, maybe I'll meet y'all at a weekend resort. Put your eyes on the prize and you can't realize that your little girl's life's so short. Brother, you need a plan. ought to understand.